Yo, so I'm not sure if you'll lie, you know, but before I started doing MMA, I started off as at a kung fu school. There was a lot of life lessons that I learned and stuff, and I don't know, things weren't always going that well at home, so this was always sort of a release to me, and it was like my second family, honestly. So if y'all are curious about what a kung fu school looks like, it looks like this. Yo, this dude, the Marasap, man, my sifu ain't here today. Anyways, on my Boston trip, I went to go see my grandma. She didn't even remember me, man. Fucking bummer, dude. I guess, like, seeing my grandma not remembering me definitely helped me put sort of things in perspective, you know? And made me really appreciative of, like, how important our memories are. Because I don't know, I remember all those times where she bought me McDonald's and shit and fed my fat ass, and watching her get older, it sort of kills me, dude, that she can't remember it. I can't really blame her, because honestly, I only come back maybe once, twice a year. I'm just very appreciative of the memories I have, and I'm very thankful of it. I think even a year or two ago, I probably would have like been like, oh fuck, man, this sucks, but it's not necessarily a bad thing. Things happen all the time.
Motherfucking Chinatown.
China motherfucking Pearl.
This is where the infamous Batters Up video was shot.
Yo, as I'm walking down my Chinatown hood, it's kind of sad, dude. I don't really recognize too many things anymore. New shit's popping up. Feels really weird walking through an area that was part of your childhood back in the day. And a few years later, you're like, what the fuck, there's so much new shit. You recognize it, but you don't. And it's that weird in-between feeling. Just a random thought, man. Yo, so back in the day, all the ABGs and teeny boppers used to chill right over here, baby.
Motherfucking frog pond.
As I'm walking around Boston by myself, man, it brings back so many memories of my high school, my college years, everything, dude. And it sort of makes me actually really happy knowing that I've changed so much throughout the years, you know? When I left Boston, I was still like a kid, man, but now that I'm getting my own paper and shit and growing up, even starting refugee hustle and whatnot, I feel like, it's a good thing, you know? And I'm very appreciative for all the memories I have here. But it sort of makes me realize that maybe I've outgrown this place, you know? I'm a criminal, jaywalking in action. I'm not a badass. What a bitch. Yo, I just bought 10 of these bad boys for my spyglass roommates, bro.
Marco.
Dude, I don't know why, but I'm fucking craving pho at my college joint. I used to go to this joint all fucking time. It's not even that great, but for some reason I always crave it. What up? This is my college staple.